Welcome to another Minecraft World Editor tutorial. This one is going to be about rivers. The previous video was a talking about rivers, so what basically to keep in mind if you want to build a kind of authentic and for Minecraft standards natural riverside. And in this video now I want to explain how I'm always building these. And basically what I'm going to do is to start here with a tiny little spring. Usually I'd start in a mountainous area where it makes most sense that the water comes out of the ground as a spring. But in this case I simply want to show you a few things on a very short distance how I'm doing it, because making a whole river takes a lot of time. So basically I'm going to start here with a little brook, then have it go down until about somewhere around here. And then I'm going to make it broader and show you how it would usually continue into the landscape. So first of all, as I said, I'm starting with a brook here and with the springs that the brook originates from. So basically in the beginning, I'm not really using World Edit for that. I'm just going to think up a path that the brook should take. So this is my destination, but I don't want to go straight for it. I don't want to make a straight line to it. I want it to be a little bit squiggly line-ish, so I'm gonna think up of a way, of a pattern to make it, and I think here I want to have it a little bit broader. It's sometimes nice to just add a few like kind of pools where the water can collect and then flow on. And I'm just gonna go like this, and then I'm gonna go down here, and now the water obviously makes a drop. Now you could dig deeper in order for it to end up once again being encased by blocks, because you don't want the water just to be like placed right here so it spreads to all the sides. So it has to be encased by the blocks to the sides. So basically you can go and make it in a stairway here, in a staircasey way. I think it's kind of nice to have a tiny drop here, and then once we are here I'm going to once again make a little turn here, because I still don't want to keep going straight forward to this up until here. Then it makes a drop again, and then I think it would be nice to go around and make a squiggly line again somehow, some kind like this. And then I'm just gonna first of all I think this is okay. So we are going to end up here. This is going to be a little bit more of a pool here, like this. That's okay. And here, down here, I simply want to have it a little bit broader, so I'm just gonna get rid of a few blocks here and there. Maybe there, and maybe these two. Looks kind of okay. In the beginning, it's hard to really make weird and, well, authentical and nice shapes, because it's you're just so much limited because of the lack of size, of course. So now basically this is the rough shape I want to go for. So as you can see, I didn't just go straight in line, but I squiggled it down a little bit. And now I want to release the water, release the Kraken. And now we're just going to go for this, and I'm just going to fill in the water with water buckets here. Is that enough? Yeah, it is. To go down here, we need to place one more block there. There we go. Alright. And down here, of course, we once again need to place the water manually. Or you could, of course, jump in here and do fix water and then a radius, for example, 20 in this case. So it would... Why didn't it fix here? Whatever. As you can see, but it filled in the water over here. So... this is the first part, and now I want to decorate it. For that, what I'm going to do is to take a pickaxe, or basically any tool that you can bind a command to, and then go for a brush sphere, and then what are we going to do? I basically want to make a gravelly riverbed and riverside, or basically brookside, for this tiny little thing that we built here. So for this impression, I don't just want to take gravel, because it will look too plain and too simple. I'm going to take 40% of gravel, which is ID 13 here. Of course, you could type out gravel. Then I want to go with 30% 1, which is simply stone. And then I want to go with 15% cobblestone. This is up to you. I kind of like having a little bit of a darker material in it from time to time. If you don't want to use a building material for the brooks and rivers, then just leave it away. And then I'm going to take three, which the remaining 15% is going to be three, so basically dirt. And then I'm going to take a radius of two. And then, of course, I think I have a mask enabled, so I'm going to mask two and three. So basically dirt, grass and dirt in this order. And I think I have a G mask from earlier enabled. Okay, and now I'm just going to go around here. Do it like this. Go down the riverside. There we go. And now I'm still gonna take, because in this case, for my standards, it doesn't really look okay-ish, because there's a strict and straight border here. You can see that exactly this is where I placed the sphere, or basically the brush. So I kind of want to make it blend in with the surroundings a little bit more. For that, once again, I'm gonna change the brush to let's once again take sphere, and then let's take two. So basically grass with a radius of two, and then mask the previous material. So 13, 1, 4, and 3. No, 3 not. I'm not gonna mask the dirt, because I don't want to get rid of the dirt that is in the riverbed, because like here, well, it's just one block in this case, but I don't want this to turn into grass later on, because it's underneath the water. And then I'm gonna carefully go, wait, I think I made a mistake. Yeah, I did. Let's just keep it like this. So I'm just gonna click here and get rid of a few blocks at the borders, so that it's not too far away from the actual river. But I'm gonna leave out some of these so that it looks a little bit more random. One here, there we go, and one or two blocks more gone here. And then I'm just gonna take a few blocks and randomly put them in here close to the water, so that we get a few patches of grass right next to the river itself, or to the brook. Like here and there. It's always nice to have it in a diagonal line of a block where it, well, of another grass block like this. One here and maybe one more here. Okay. And therefore it immediately looks a little bit more randomized, a little bit more natural, because there would not only be stone next to the river like this. I think this is enough for the beginning. So let's carry on here. So this one is going to be a little bit broader from now on. So I want to carry on with the river from here. Of course, what you can do is to start with another kind of brook from another spring coming down here, for example, meeting up here so that the river is allowed to be a little bit broader, because once there's more water, of course, you can make it broader. So basically what I want to do now is to continue this down here. And for that, I'm digging up a kind of trench, but in this case, now I'm just going to take welded, which is also something immediately when the river is a little bit broader, then I'm using welded for it, because it would be stupid to, well, get rid of all the dirt and to kind of dig the trench without welded if the river is broader. So basically, I'm going to take a brush sphere of air, so zero. And then just one. We need to get rid of the mask that we had before. And then I'm just gonna dig in a few holes. The reason why I'm not doing this with a cylinder is because I want the ground from now on, this riverbed, to be lowered one block more than it was before, so that the river is getting deeper. And then I'm going to go for this edge right here. Then I want to go down this. I'm going to do this manually here, like this. This is going to be quite straight. And then one block more down, like this. And then we want to continue somehow, like in this manner here. Okay. For demonstration sakes, this is pretty much enough. Yep. So now I'm going to simply make the riverbed a little bit more nice, a little bit nicer. So sometimes it's nice to have a few shallow parts on the sides here. And here I'm gonna dig even a little bit deeper, just for this tiny section here. Then maybe make it like this. I'm always trying to get rid of the patterns of world edit so that you don't immediately see that this was world edited, which is a problem with many things, with many builds that you encounter, that you can see that there's a brush shape or a circle, a sphere shape, or this is a cylinder shape, a perfect circle, for example. That's always an indicator for, well, basically people to see that you used world edit. And it's always nice to make it so that people can see that this wasn't the typical Minecraft generation, that it wasn't generated, that was the word I was looking for, that it wasn't generated by the default Minecraft, world generation, but that it still does not look like world edit. So I'm just gonna add a little few things here, and then I'm gonna fix the water from now on. Wait, no, we have to go from here. So I'm gonna do fix water, and then just 20 should be enough, which is basically a command that expands the water wherever it is able to go, it will go. And then here it's supposed to go one block down like this, and can carry on here, and then it's supposed to go one block further down like here, like this, and then here it's gonna go down even further, and once again like this. Okay, and now I'm gonna fix water again. You can leave it like this if you like to have kind of rapids going down here, which would make sense. Sometimes it's even nice to, for example, pick stone blocks and then just put up a few stone blocks here so that the rapids make actually sense, because the water water would come from here, then have a narrow place where it has to fit through and would fall down, and this way the rapids would basically occur in the first place. So this is just an example. Of course, you'd go about it and make a few more stone blocks here and there, so that it actually makes sense that these are not the only stones occurring in the area here. Like this, for example. And now I'm just gonna leave it like this, but down here I want to fix the water, because this looks too messy, and it wouldn't make sense that the water is coming from the sides. Where's the water coming from? From here, right? There's no spring here. So we need to fix this. For that I'm going to go with fix water and a radius of 2 in this case, because I don't want to mess up too much. Then I'm going to do it... Am I going to do it? Yeah, okay. I'm going to do it once more from here. So you have always to have a radius that... Whoops, that was too much. Because I was underwater. Oh great, I messed it up. Let's get rid of this water here, and here, and there, and there we go. Okay, because what I wanted to do was to have simply this one block here disappear. There we go, that was what I wanted to do. Okay, and now, of course, I need to fix the water here, but here I can do it with a little bit, more blocks, like that. Okay, and now you can see I moved one block deeper than I originally had to. We moved down, I think, 4 layers here, and I moved down 5 blocks. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I want to get away from the blocks, or basically from the river, being just one block deep, or basically being the water starting directly at the ground level that you're walking on, and then drop in deep, but I want it to be that you are walking here and actually have a riverside that you have to go down one block and then drop into the water. And the reason for that is because I'm now gonna get rid of a few blocks here. Once again, don't take away too many blocks, but not, don't do it like here. You can see there's exactly always one block in a row going around here. And this once again doesn't look very natural, so what I'm going to do is to take away a few more blocks, maybe even put up one block here and there, so that it's not always the same amount of blocks to each side. So basically maybe something like this. Yep, that's okay. And now I would continue building the river here. But for the demonstration and for to explain to you how to make these rivers, this should be enough for the length. So I'm just gonna do the same thing again what we did over here. So basically I'm once again going to go brush, sphere, and then 30% gravel, 30% stone, 15% cobblestone, and then I'm gonna go, I think this time with a little bit more, so we have 25% left, and that's gonna go, that's gonna be dirt. And now I'm gonna once again mask 2. I don't want to get rid of the stone that we placed here, so I'm just gonna mask 2 and 3. Let's not mask 3 right now because I don't want to get rid of too much of the dirt. And what was our radius? We need a radius of 2. Okay, and now I'm just gonna I'm just gonna do what we did earlier. So I'm just gonna go along the riverside, place these like that. Okay, and in this case, usually I'd go about it with another brush for the floor here, but I want to keep it mostly made out of dirt. So I'm just going to add a few blocks here and there. Just once again a randomized pattern. This is a randomization. The same kind of randomization that's going on with my regular buildings is going on here. So basically, from time to time, just place a block. It doesn't really matter exactly where. Just place them somewhere. And I think it would be nice to interrupt this line of dirt here. So I'm just going to place it here. Maybe one more here, and there we go. And I'm also getting rid of these grass blocks. Okay, of course I could do this with a brush, but I preferred in this case to do it manually, because you have way more control over especially which kind of blocks exactly you want to get rid of. So I'm just going to go this, and then a little bit more stone here, and there, and there, and there, and there we go. And now you can decide. Sometimes it's nice to have these patches of dirt that you that won't turn into grass, except for this one. This one will turn into grass because it's right next to it. There is actually a grass block in 1.7. that doesn't turn into, or that doesn't, yeah, turn into grass. Sorry, dirt block that doesn't turn into grass. And there's, of course, the new 1.8 block, coarse dirt, I think, that doesn't turn into grass. So this is also a nice thing that you can do here. I'm just gonna green these regions here because I want it to be a little bit more tidy. So I'm just gonna go like this. Alright, I think this is about alright. So in this case this looks a little bit weird because the river all of the sudden gets broader. Usually, as I said, it would make sense to have another brook coming in from the side, at least like here, somehow to get into this pool here, and then go a little bit broader, or to simply wait. You can, of course, without adding another brook from the side, you can make the brook broader after a time, but it should be a longer period than this one. So basically, I would continue building the brook like this up until at least down here, then make it broader one or two blocks, then continue it up until here, then have it meet with another brook that would, for example, come from this hillside, so that it can, that there can be a pool of water. So this basically we could keep this this little river, this little lake here, and then the river could continue making its way down here. Oh, by the way, hello, Cargathol Tower. We are in my tutorial area after all. Okay, but as you can see here, this already looks okay, except for of course this weird thing. And then what I usually do is simply to have some kind of decoration for the sides. So either go with regular trees or big trees, or edit your own trees. Some people don't like the default Minecraft trees. I don't mind them too much. Of course, they are not the prettiest thing you've ever seen, but it's gonna be okay. And sometimes it's nice to have a few trees. I realize these... Well, let's get rid of three of them. Because they were just exactly in the same distances to one another. So basically, it would make sense to have a few trees next to the water. Because, well, after all, it's water, and water brings life, obviously. Even if there's not a forest around, you can still place a few trees. But don't make the mistake that I just did to exactly place the trees in the exact same distance to one another. Maybe have another tree here, whatever. Here. A tree can't go there, a tree can't go there. Just place one, damn it. Alright. And then for the grass on the side, which I will obviously want to add, I will go with a brush, sphere, and then air. 80% air, then 15% 31-1, which is tall grass, and then 5% 31-2, which are the tiny little ferns. And then with a radius of 8, then I need to mask every block above a grass block. So basically, this is the command, right? So you mask everything, like X. X, that is... thank you. Thanks, Java. What? 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 Damn you. There we go. Thank you. Oh, I lost the command. Okay. So, mask X... So everything that is above the grass block, and then I will go gmask gmask 0, so air, so that it only replaces the air blocks. And I do hope that it... Yep, there we go. And therefore, as you can see, I'm placing tall grass and these ferns here. But not on every block, which is totally ugly if you have all the grass blocks be covered by tall grass. But only some, or basically, well, 15% out of the air blocks that are available. Then go around here and there, and there we go. So this makes adding greenery a lot easier. Okay, and basically this is it so far. I would go, of course, deeper. For example, if we were to carry on, I would do the same thing again. So, do I still have it? Of course, we have to get rid of the G mask, and we have to get rid of the mask. No. Okay. So basically, what I would do is to go on with a brush sphere 0-2, for example, and then make it deeper and broader. And so on. So basically, I would do the same thing that we did just now, and then make the river continue. And as I said in the previous video, I would make a little S shape, for example. So this would be the flow of the river, like going on like this. Of course, you always have to keep your surroundings in mind, and have the same height of the water, so that it doesn't that the level of water doesn't have to go up. Just in order to, for example, get across this hill. But in this case, it would be nice because the water would still be on this level here. So we can go down one block more, so that it actually is deeper if you're standing here, that you have to go down like 5 blocks in order to get to the water. It's always nice to have these kind of distances. And then I would add this kind of thing here. There we go. And then later on put a few trees on it and stuff like that. So basically this is how I would go about it. But this is the same thing that we did for the part up here. Simply a little bit larger, a little bit broader, and then the same kind of decoration afterwards for the same river. So basically I do think if you just try a little bit, it will be better for you to simply try out a few things. 20 minutes of simply experimenting a little bit with several kind of river shapes is more, well, effective for your learning than me talking 10 more minutes about what I would do, because it's still going to be the same, except for that it's going to be a little bit broader and a little bit deeper, of course. So yeah, basically that is pretty much it. I do hope you enjoyed this quick world edit tutorial. And if there's any other suggestions for other world edit tutorials, other things that you have seen on my server that you like, for example, and that you would like me to make a tutorial about, or something that you've been struggling with for a long time, then post them in the comments, then I will know what to do. And well, with that, I do think this is pretty much it. So as always, please rate, comment, subscribe, join the crew, come and make your datos. You will end up, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.